So now that you've got everything installed, it's ready to get going with an App Engine app. We've created a very simple Hello World App Engine application that uses endpoints. You can find it in the Lesson 2 folder that you downloaded from the Udacity GitHub repo for this course. What we're going to do now is import the project into Eclipse. To import a Maven project into Eclipse, you go up to the Eclipse menu, you choose File, and then you choose Import. Then you open up the Maven folder and choose Existing Maven Projects, and then click Next. Then you can browse to the folder that has the project that you want to import. I unzip my folder in Hello World Endpoints. You have to select the folder itself. And then if you want, in Advanced, you can specify the name or you can use the default name. Make sure that the pom.xml is selected. Click Next. You may see you get some errors, particularly the endpoints get discovery doc. Don't worry about that, just leave it as resolve later and say Finish. It'll ask you, if you have the error, you'll get a little error message asking you if you really want to continue. Just say OK, you do. And then the project comes in. It's a little hard to see here, but my project is Hello World. So this project that you imported, the Hello World Endpoints project, is a complete working app. It's very simple, but it's complete. It works. And you can run it out of the box. So I'm going to show you how to run it first, and then we're going to look into the code that makes up the project. So when you're ready to run your project, go over here, you choose it, right-click the project, choose Run As, and then go ahead and choose Run Configurations. You can create a new launch configuration by clicking this New Launch Configuration button up here. Then enter the base directory, which is where your project is. But you can use this variable $:project_lock. That points to the directory where your project is. The goal, you need to set it to appengine:dev server. And down here in the Maven runtime, you need to make sure that the external Maven runtime is selected. So it must say external, not internal. If you need to configure it, then you click Configure and make sure that the global settings from installation directory points to where your Maven is installed. If you can't remember where your Maven's installed, hop over to a terminal console window. And hopefully during the Maven installation process, you define the variable m2_home. So you can go ahead and just echo that. So I say OK and say Apply. And then right here, I could go ahead and run it or I could close it, but I'll run it now. And you see it starts compiling. And you see here it's retrieving the Google App Engine Java SDK from Maven. And that's because in the pom.xml, we specified the Google App Engine SDK as one of the dependencies. The first time you run it, it does take a while because Maven has to go off and get all the libraries and everything that make up the dependencies in your project. And when it's finished, you'll see build success. So the build success means it's finished building and now it's going to actually start running it. And when the project is running on the dev server on localhost, you see this message, info dev app server is now running. So let's make sure it really is. So open a browser and go to a new tab and go to localhost:8080. And if for any reason your app is running on a different port, then just use a different port. But I expect it'll be localhost:8080. And look, the app is running. We're not actually going to run the app. I mean, you're welcome to run it if you want to, but that's not what we're going to look at next. So now I just want to show you how to deploy to AppSpot. So back here in Eclipse, go ahead and select your project, right-click it, again choose Run As and Run Configurations. Click New to add a new configuration. Again, add the base directory, and I can just copy that variable into my new configuration. Now, this time we want to deploy to AppSpot. So for that, you have to add the goal appengine:update. So here's the goal appengine:update. Again, make sure that the Maven runtime says external. Now you can run it. Now the first time you run it though, you're going to need to give permission to the App Engine CFG application, which is an App Engine application that will upload your App Engine application. And you'll see that it's asking permission to view and manage your applications deployed on Google App Engine. You are going to need to accept this. And after you accept it, you'll see that it shows you a code. It says, please copy this code and paste it. So go ahead and copy the entire code. And then go back to Eclipse and enter the code. Hit return, and it will keep going. Oh no, goodness, I got another error, 403 forbidden. You do not have permission to modify this app. App ID equals your app ID. Oh no, wait, that's not my app ID. I forgot to configure the appengineweb.xml. And you're going to need to do this too. So you go into the source directory, SRC, source, and then into the main. Not looking at Java just now. You need to go into the web apter. Then you need to go into web and inf. And you see appengineweb.xml. And this file is where you configure the properties that are very specific to AppEngine. And the most important one for deploying to AppEngine is you have to enter the app ID of your project. And this is the ID that you set in the developer console over on console.developers.com. So go ahead and enter your app ID here, save the file, and try running again. Now this time, just go to Run As, Maven Build, and pick the Run Configuration for App Engine Update. I forgot to name mine, but here I see it's App Engine Update. Okay, good. It's beginning the interaction. See, it's initiating, it's cloning, it's uploading. Then it reaches a point where it's pretty much uploaded stuff, but it needs to ping the app to verify. And you'll see these messages. We'll check again in 1-2 seconds and so on. And at this point, all it's really doing is just trying to ping the app. Can sometimes get hung here, but usually this doesn't take very long. Okay, good. So now, then again, you see build success. Now this means that my app's now been deployed to AppSpot. Let's go check. So to visit your app running on AppSpot, you go to your app ID, whatever that is. And then after your app ID, you do .appspot.com, and it should take you to your app. And this looks exactly the same as it did on localhost, but actually we're now running it on AppSpot. So one more thing I wanted to mention in your project is that after you deploy it, whether you deploy it to localhost or you deploy it to AppSpot, the target directory gets populated with all the compiled code. So you could actually delete the target directory and then rerun your project and it would get recreated.